Hello everyone, this is Slagface, welcome back to Spellcross. We're going to continue with our efforts today, conquering some of these areas, and continue with the research. We've met the mechanical tower for the first time last time, so that's our priority. I want to know a little bit more about them. However, I am going to lower the amount of research down to 13 to get us some money, and we've set some upgrades to our units, so we're waiting two turns anyway. And now it's basically we are not pressed by any quests, so we have all the time we need to finish up those quests and alternatively to upgrade our units. It is quite possible that we will get attacked at some point. It seems that the forces of darkness have a new enemy called Karadanka. It would appear that they are more afraid of him than anyone else. Okay, so it's one unit, but it's some guy called Karadanka. So it's gonna be probably some kind of a leader we will engage in the last mission. And we've successfully finished the research, and 13 points was even more than we needed. Now we have 74. And can we recruit now? But we could probably upgrade someone. This is the new unit. It could benefit from the upgrades, but I am actually going to wait and buy the new AMX-13. I've decided last time that I want one more, and I have to buy a new one, because another unit can't be upgraded into aerial guns, so I have to start leveling him up from the scratch, and since he's weak in the beginning, I want to do it as soon as possible. And I'm going to start a new research. We finished up this area. So what's it gonna be? Let's finish up the races research. We want to take a look in the golem. And also while we're at it, let's read the flavor text of the mechanical tower that we've just researched. It was the ugly wooden tower with some guns. This mechanism is the first product of the attempts to copy the armored forces of the Alliance. These complicated constructions rely on selected orcs bred especially to bear heavy loads. Heavily armored, these machines with chassis on wheels possess certain firepower concentrated in several cannons loaded from the front side. Fire heavy pieces of metal at our troops and vehicles. Yes, we've seen that. Even though they were quite clumsy, or they were supposed to be clumsy, they were pretty effective at destroying us. So new research is set. We've finished new research. And we have enough money to buy the AMX, because it's quite cheap. Let's do that. And I will have to wait another two turns to incorporate him into our ranks. And we can read a little bit more about the golem. Where is it? Here. Golem. The body of these creatures is composed of stone and clay. By their appearance and clumsy movement, they resemble a golem. Massive armor is its main advantage, and that's why they are frequently engaged as an effective means against tanks and artillery. Their weapons are flashes of energy that they shoot at their enemy. The flashes come from the upper limbs. These magic attacks cause our machines to malfunction. They pose a deadly threat to armored units, and the infantry has trouble fighting them. Yeah, they're quite sturdy. Okay, let's continue with the research, and yes, let's research about Mri, about the sand people. While we're waiting. And we finished up the research as well. Yeah, I'm not really interested in new commanders. Even though Leroy. No. I would bar him, but I can't. I would have to fire another commander of mine, and I'm not going to do that. They already have some experience. That would be a huge loss. I'm going to recruit those guys, and that sets me back another turn. Can I upgrade someone with something at least? While I'm waiting, an engine maybe? Gun? Maybe? Yeah. I'll rather upgrade him with a better gun. And yeah, we can finally research about harpies. I have a feeling I should probably rather conserve money, but I'm still counting on money from these new areas we're going to conquer now. So the Mri. Mri are desert creatures whose origin is unknown to us. They move in the grey and light blue clothes, which are typical for normal nomads. As battle units, they are valued mainly for their ability to communicate with the desert. Unfortunate units frequently die in sandstorms. The greatest losses have been suffered by our armored units, where skilled infantry units manage to disperse quickly and thus minimize their losses. In deserts, the Mri represent one of the most dangerous opponents for all types of ground units. Yes, all types of ground units. That's very true. They do resemble Fremen from Dune a little bit, I think. Let's wait, it was the harpies. Amount of 6 was added to your total. So I can actually decrease to 11. Set up ballista for research, and let's read about harpies. This episode will be more lore-based and lore-orientated than I thought. Harpy, if you can remember them, those were the flying winged ladies that screamed and took my action points. Instead of human hands, they have pseudo fingers, terminating in sharp claws. The harpies attack mostly from the air. They aren't protected by armor, but their speed helps them avoid the heavy fire of guns from the ground. Anti-aircraft guns and choppers pose a deadly threat to them. The harpies serve as auxiliary troops in enemy military actions. The harpies can raise their vocal cords to dangerous levels and are also able to paralyze with their song. The harpies were brought to Earth by forces of darkness, darkness masters, but they are less than obedient. Their inclination to gather and their bird-like instinct to protect their nests is so prevailing that our troops have managed to use it against them by attacking their nests high up in the mountains. There are large numbers of captives in the harpies' bases, where they work as slaves and serve as food for the harpies. The harpies young. The permanent need for slaves is the reason that the harpies attack civil centers and the general population. I didn't know about that. We're almost finished. China has surrendered to the forces of darkness. Reports received from deserting officers say that nerve gas is being used against the civilian population. Well, that's not very good. We finished the research on ballista. It's troubling news. I would expect they would attack or something. Yes, and let's read about the ballista. I already know that very well. The ballista is a primitive mechanical weapon based on the pulling of a bowstring. This time, it's a mechanism on a wheeled chassis on which a 3.5 meter arrow is placed. The hit itself wouldn't be so dangerous for the modern heavily armored Alliance tanks if it didn't have a spike made of an unknown metal. The ballista is the only anti-tank device. The arrow is able to rip off the turret, or it can flip the entire tank upside down. Despite this fact, the ballistae have only a small chance of surviving an attack. The infantry simply roll over them, and our tanks have a long enough range to swiftly do away with them. The only salvation for the ballista is an immediate and effective assault on attacking units. And they do that. So let's choose an area to attack. We have three choices. Forces of Darkness reinforcements use a route through this area instead of using a much nearer route. Why don't they use this route? Okay. There is an oil field in the area. It would be useful to have it under our control after we conquer it. Experts will arrive and install oil towers. Thus, our fuel reserves should increase. So it's probably be more money here. The Forces of Darkness burial ground was detected in the area, so I would expect undead, which means quite a lot of experience. I could level up my new unit there, so I will attack there. But yeah, I haven't started a new research, and I think I will get into technologies. The older races that we already know about unlocked those two upgrades, but we already have a better upgrade for our tanks and armor, so we are not even going to research those probably ever, unless I don't have anything else to research and have quite a lot of money, which is which is possible in this difficulty setting. So let's start with the new guns technology. Right, the new AMX is already in the unit, but the unit is incomplete and I have no commander for them yet, unfortunately. We need to drive the Forces of Darkness away from this area. Besides the usual enemy squads, the undead could well appear near the burial ground. Yes, so they are here. Map is quite large. And I can already see a hill here, so, and there's a gorge here. Spawn as far as back as I can. Okay, so let's try to look around. Next target, sir. There will be some flatlands here and some units. But I'm interested in this section actually. See what's here. So far it looks quite flat. And there is some higher ground. Okay, some hill. That might be a good position. It might also be a good place to ambush. Nothing so far. Does that mean that I will have chance to run away? Okay, there they are. Yes, and I guess they see me. So we have some undead. Good. Golem, Magotar, Medi. And some Kaorks. Alright, let's try to run away. They haven't seen me. Well, why? Okay, let's try it again. Let's try it from here. This is load. Yes, regroup a little bit, because there is a nasty group there. No, 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 no. I want it differently. Yeah, like this long-range weapons first. That still doesn't solve the problem of safely getting their attention. Okay, now I see them, so they can't get opponent fire. Now they should see me, and hopefully I can get away without being obliterated. Seems so. Maybe I will get some shots by sand people, obviously, and the golem will probably have a shot. No, I haven't even lost one yet. I'm utterly amazed. Do they still feel like it? Yes, especially the undead. The undead will follow me, and then I believe that the others will follow the undead. Yes, here we go! A new level with the first shot fired in this mission. Why not? Yeah, even highly upgraded, the Magotar are no match for the superior firepower of my absolutely incapable mortar, as they can't even reach those guys. Well, let's give you this experience. Yes. Well, take a shot. Move a little bit back so they can get more opponent fire. Yes, this would be a nice opportunity for you to get some experience. The advantage of the bridge is that not so many of them can get to me at once. All of my... okay. All of the flamethrower units are fully upgraded, and it shows. Don't kill them, please. I would really love to give the experience to the new tank, or maybe the new AA gun. Yeah, I didn't expect that he is attack just 8. So, no. Maybe you, the old one. I know it's extremely difficult to hit them, but he's almost max level. That's very good. I might... oh no. They're going to burn them, aren't they? No! Good, so they're prepared. And the orcs just block their vision, and they want to keep away from me. Where is the unit? There. I will have to... this was a good thing, because I will have to open fire on this unit with my mortar. I don't want them to shoot at me from back. Well. Yeah, he's still in range, good. Let's get rid of him. Those guys will probably want to heal a little bit, but it's just 27 of them, so no real danger there. Let's damage you and use the mortar on... yeah, let's use them on Magotar, because if they manage not to kill them, good, that might be opportunity for this new AA gun to get some experience. It didn't kill it, but even still, it was half a level. Now where's the new tank? There it is. it's not much, but it's still nice. Yeah, I like the higher range because I am feeling confident. I treat this as a free range, but still the undead can give me some problems. Wasn't really expecting this to work. In that case, this mortar unit is almost leveled up to the maximum, and this is still not it, but that's okay. What about you? Yeah, let's use your insane amount of attacks. Well, if you had to. I wonder if someone will go around. And there will be another Marine. Yes, they are going around. Of course they are. Now there is a golem. I want to open fire on that. The undead can wait. And as the Marie before, he should be in range of this APC as well. And not that effective against them, but how about you? You would have to move quite a lot. So let's rather use you against those guys. Too much range there. Don't burn them down. I don't trust you guys. You will kill them. I don't trust the mortar either. They can get some critical hit, and I don't expect the tank to kill them. Well, maybe. No, he missed. Gotta keep them alive, actually. Yeah, they're just walking experience at this moment, and the golem is not going to try it. Yeah, he's waiting for another golem, and those orcs are also cautiously waiting. So this golem is going to hit someone, probably this mortar APC. It would be a good thing to ride out and shoot it, but not really sure. It's far away. Yes, finish him up. Finish him off. Still constantly saying finish him up. This could work if you hit, but yeah, you almost got 4th level, that's important. And the other tanks also need some experience. I'm still using the other units, forgetting about my main tank force. And they also need experience still. I'll try to finish the last level of the first mortar infantry with this attack. It's probably not going to be enough. It's just orcs? No, it wasn't enough. Now, what would I have to do? No, it's too far. It's too far away, and I wouldn't even get in range because you get a penalty for crossing the bridge. So I have to wait, actually, and hope for the best. Yeah, good. Well, it's not good, but he attacked the new tank, which will be quite cheap to repair, as they're not very high level. Can you at least shoot at him? You can't. But if you moved here, you still have retain two attacks. and then you will be able to shoot at him, and you won't.
Receiving.
I also want you to get some experience fighting heavier units.
Receiving. Understand.
I will try to kill you with my AA.
Understand.
Gun, a tank.
Receiving.
Soften you with another tanks.
Understand.
I hope you won't kill them, but if you will, whatever. Yes. 5.
Understand.
If they hit, they shoot. Kill them, yes. And it was almost another level. Good. And it raised their attack. Okay. That's desperately needed. Now I would like the damaged tank to finish off this golem, if possible. If I will even be able to kill it. Now it's just one golem, so let's see. Yes! It's almost fifth level. Now it's going to be more expensive to repair him. Well, well. I would expect the undead to do something.
Receiving. Receiving.
I would like you, the new guy, to kill the undead, actually.
I understand. Next target, sir.
Did they run away?
Receiving.
They went to regroup, didn't they?
I understand.
So let's actually move there a bit.
Receiving.
With my least experienced units.
Receiving. Receiving.
These guys can hold their ground here. There he is.
Receiving. Next target, sir.
Oh, can use the hammer as well.
Receiving.
It's absolutely not effective. 2 undead. If he hits, he is going to kill them. He didn't, and the undead can't do really that much. They can scream. It didn't do anything yet. Come on. You get it. And you have third attack. Why? Well, that's strange. It seems like he has 4 attacks now, or I'm blind, maybe. How can he have 4 attacks now when Major Garovsky here has 2 more levels? And he jumped from 2 attacks to 2 attacks to 4 attacks. It's similar to just these commandos having 5 attacks. Is there a chance when they level up that they get more numbers of attacks instead of attack power? Because we can see that they are considerably weaker even now. Well, that might be because Major has... Can we see it? No. We can see the bonus for +2, and he has +2. Yeah, he doesn't have the upgrades, I think. Oh, I don't remember. Anyway, it's strange. It's not like I'm complaining. He's already at 4 attacks. He's now quite useful. The power is also in the number of attacks, not just power of the of an attack, because if I'm not able to hit them, and there's no use in being strong. Now I'm dividing my forces a little bit, and they are not blind, but I'm quite confident that I could deal with almost anything now. But they're doing something, they're moving some there in the shadows, and might attack me with something. But I've destroyed two golems. So that was all that was in this group. I've killed one or two melee units. How about I killed this guy? They're still somewhere. As the Magotar is flying, their moves take quite a long time, which means they're moving there. Attack him from here now, but yes, this is was exactly what I hoped is going to happen, because that gave you the third level. When you buy a new unit and land some successful shots, they level up very quickly, but it's actually difficult to keep them alive. So now we're almost in the sort of middle of the map, if I can move in this area. And 45 there on top might be a good place. I'm not sure if it's wise to move them separately, but I'm going to try it. Okay, that wasn't very smart. At least two melee units. But so far I haven't lost that many tanks, but I would like to see them. Can I do it with Hammer now? So that means that they're here. I will have to jump them. There they are. Okay. Let's try to... how I'm going to do it. A mortar unit can almost reach them. Let's move back with the damaged tanks. So far I've lost just two. I need to retain three attacks, okay. And you got a new level. Got even stronger. You open fire on those guys. In case I wouldn't be able, I will be able to kill them, but in case I wouldn't be able, I want them as weak as possible. Something like this. That's why I'm not really afraid. I will lose some tanks while trying to reach them, but then this might be your last shot for a new level. Yes, 22. Yeah, well, a decent attack. I still have reason to use them. Now I just hope that there won't be more. There is. Now it's gonna hurt. How many? They totally surprised me. Don't kill them off. How many are there? Has to be at least 3, maybe 4. Don't kill them. What is going on? Yes, well, let's load. I just want to see them. Okay. Okay, I see. So it was 5. I got jumped, I got baited and killed. I will keep this in so you can see it. I was overconfident and I got absolutely obliterated. Now I have to load it to the beginning. But I'll fight on and get back into roughly the same situation. I'll move all of them to this side and up on those hills, because then those guys won't be so dangerous. I thought they will be like one. Well.